Hi, I'm Jamie, and welcome to Teachers Tech. I recently did a video about how you could use the switch function in Microsoft Excel to replace the if function. Now I want to go a step further and show you how you should be using XLOOKUP instead of the switch function. It's far superior. So I'm going to redo the examples that I did in the switch function video and show you how it could be better done with using XLOOKUP in Microsoft Excel. If you'd like to follow along with today's tutorial, I'll put a link to this practice sheet down below in the description so you can click on it, download it, and create these formulas as we go along. Here's the first example that I showed using the switch formula. And if you want to check out that video, I'll put a link up above in the card and down below in the description. You can see the switch is still here and I'm going to replace this one. The switch, very easy to use, a little bit cleaner than the ifs function because I don't have to make the reference to the cell each time. I can just go ahead and write it like so. But using XLOOKUP is probably the approach you should be using with a separate range or table. So I could have this on a different sheet. If I go ahead and start my XLOOKUP function right here, I'm going to go and still reference the same cell that I did before. Now I just have to go and have my different ranges chosen through here. So I'm going to pick my first one. Now my second one here, if I was copying it down, I'm just going to go ahead and absolute those ones right there. And I can also say to return, if the value is not there, I could return a different value. But in this case, I don't need it. So right now, I'm going to copy this down and you'll see that I get all the same results. So here was my switch formula here and here was my XLOOKUP. Now, if I want to make any changes, I can quickly, instead of going inside the formula here and making any changes, I can just go down here, write a different word, and it will quickly update dynamically into wherever I need it. So definitely advantage over XLOOKUP over switch. Here's my example number two with the switch formula. I just multiplied it by total sales and I put my commissions right in here after it identified the region. Now I'm going to redo this with XLOOKUP. I have my separate information over here. I'm going to go and start the same way. I'm still going to multiply this right here by my XLOOKUP. So I'm going to go ahead and multiply and start my XLOOKUP at this point. So when I choose this, I'm referencing this one cell also, and then I can choose my first lookup array. It's going to look up this one right through here, and then the second one is going to be this one. At this point, I'm just going to close it, and I'm going to make sure at this time, I'm going to put my absolute around all of these, just like that. And let's copy this down. I'll just drag this down all the way. And you can see it gave me the exact same information. And I find that actually a little easier. And again, making any changes to this, if the commission rates change, it's just more efficient this way to make any updates. Now, if I was going to go a step further, let's say if this was deleted, this central one right here, notice that the error that I get here. The nice thing with using the XLOOKUP now, if I go back up to this one here, I'm going to add one more thing. So if I go here, let's say if it's nothing there, I'm going to go, if not found, I want it to be zero. So at this point, if I copy them all the way down now, that gets rid of the error because even though I don't have it written down into my region, it's just, if not found, it returned that zero there. So another reason why I like having the XLOOKUP as my first choice over switch. Here was my third example of how to use the switch function in Microsoft Excel. It was right here, and you can see I actually added an if and is blank functions as well. So what it's going to do with the is blank, if this was blank, it's going to return a zero, or if this was blank, it's going to return a zero. And I'm actually going to add this to the XLOOKUP at the end of this too. So let's go ahead and create our XLOOKUP in this cell. So I'm going to start with my equals. We're actually going to add two XLOOKUPs together. So in this case, my cell I'm going to look up is this one right here. And the first array will be the difficulty level here. Now I'm going to go to my second array, this one right here. And I'm going to make sure that I'm just going to go and use my function F4 to absolute those. Now I'm going to close this. I could have an if not found be zero, but I'm going to use the is blanks anyway. So I'm going to just leave that as it is there. So I can put my addition in and and start my XLOOKUP again. And this time it's gonna look up this cell, and we're gonna look over here at the array here, and we're gonna look at the array here. And again, I'm gonna add my my dollar signs to all of these with the simple F4 here. So I think that will do this. If I go ahead and close it just like this, I get my five across. Does it copy down here? Yes, it does. Everything is exactly the same. So remember, I wanted the is blank. So if this was blank, if this case was blank right here, notice there's an error here. So I'm going to go back and actually do the same thing that I did with the switch one. I'm going to take this formula right here, and I'm going to go ahead and just add the if right at the front. And you can see there's the if or is blank part, and then it just has the rest of it just like I wrote it before, and it did it with one more bracket at the end. So now if I copy this down here, if one of these happens to be blank like this, notice it just becomes a zero. So I hope this video has shown you why the XLOOKUP function will reign over the switch function. Switch does have its place, but you really can't compare it to how powerful the XLOOKUP is. Take a look at my other video about the how to use XLOOKUP, and I go through it step by step, giving different examples as well. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.